here for joining us in another Power Pack session provided by Global Diplomat College Center. Global Diplomat College Center mission is transforming students into leaders, leaders and agents of change. Transforming students into leaders, leaders and agents of change. I want to focus on what I believe will be the key for kingdom living in the year 2020. The Bible is called the law of God. The Bible is the constitution of the kingdom of heaven. When you're approaching the Bible, you're not approaching a religious book. You're approaching a legal document. My focus on the topic message session is Kingdom of God cannot be shaken. Kingdom of God cannot be shaken. Part one. The Lord is shaking nations. But the kingdom of God cannot be shaken. Am I making myself clear? The Lord is shaking nations globally. Fiscally, spiritually, financially, and politically. The people of Norway has been shaking this week by sheer evil, unshared against precious, innocent children. Japan has been shaken this year by a numerous earthquake. The people of Egypt, Syria, Yemen, have been shaken this year dramatically, unexpected, the revolution undergo there through the Arab world. Iran has been shaken by numerous pro-democratic movements that took the streets and by the government of Tehran. The government of Tehran. The people of Israel are being shaken by fear that Iran rapidly closing in and building a nuclear weapon. Greece had been shaken by his debt crisis, riot, and social unrest. Americans, too, are being shaken, faced with the worst economical crisis since the Great Depression. Am I making myself clear? Nations have been shaken, but the kingdom of heaven cannot be shaken. One of the great leaders of our time, his name was Albert Einstein. He quote, I quote from him on crisis, "We cannot expect things to change if we keep on doing the same things." The crisis is the greatest blessing for people and nation, because the crisis brings progress. I'll quote it again, Albert Einstein, one of the greatest physicists and one of the greatest men of his day. He quote, "We cannot expect things to change if we keep doing the same things. The crisis is the greatest blessing for people and nation, because the crisis brings progress." He called that December 17, 2010. God's original purpose is to extend and to establish his heavenly kingdom on earth through his sons and his daughter. That's his original plan. The kingdom of God will not be shaken. Heaven is a kingdom. Heaven is a kingdom. God, Elohim, I am. He is the king of that kingdom. Heaven is an invisible and a heavenly kingdom. Cannot be shaken. In the Constitution, subsection in the book of Daniel 2:44, I read, "And in the days of those kings, Lord God of heaven, his God of heaven will set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people. It shall break in pieces and consume those kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. Cannot be destroyed. It shall stand forever." God is talking about his kingdom. In subsection of the Constitution of the Bible, quote this, Hebrews 12:28-29. "Therefore, since we have receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us be thankful and worship God acceptable with reverence and awe. For God is a consuming fire too." He is a consuming fire. Underline the word receiving. It's an old English word. Means to receive. Receive means re. To receive. Receive means to have. Receive means to have and we mean to re get back again what you had. Called receive. Mean to go back to receive. The word receive means to take in one's possession. Means to accept, take hold. Means to take as something given. Means to take, gain knowledge. I'm making myself clear. If you want to receive something, you got to take it as your own possession. To accept it. To take it a hold of it. To take something given. God given you a kingdom, not a religion. It was never God's goal in his mind and his heart to have Christians and a religion. Christian is not, God never called us Christian, neither the Bible. God never intend to have a religion. God's goal to all humanity is to receive a kingdom. The word kingdoms means sovereignty. The word kingdom means dominion. The word kingdom means reign. The word kingdom means kingdom of God. The word kingdoms mean world power. The word kingdoms mean control, government, rule over. It was an all God plan to give you a kingdom. He's never planned to give you a religion. It was never in God's plan to give you a religion. But it's always in his plan to give you a kingdom. Am I making myself clear? It was always in God's plan to give you a kingdom. It was never in his plan to give you a religion. But it's always in his plan to give you a kingdom. Am I making myself clear to you? That was his plan. That receive a kingdom in your life. What is a kingdom? A kingdom is a government led by a king. What is a kingdom? A government led by a king. Receive the kingdom of God. Christianity. It's the largest religion on the earth. They introduce you to Jesus. They preach a message about Jesus, but they never preach the message Jesus preached. Jesus' first inauguration message is Matthew 4:17. From that time, Jesus began to preach. What? Repent. Change your heart. Change your mind. Change the way you used to live. Change your lifestyle. Because the kingdom of heaven have arrived. God's plan for all mankind is to extend His heavenly kingdom in their heart on earth is called the kingdom of God in their heart on earth. In subsection Mark 10, 14, 15. Christianity and many religious groups have misunderstood, a misconception of what Jesus taught. Jesus never preached the blood, never preached Calvary, never preached the cross, never preached the resurrection, never preached born again. Jesus Christ only preached two messages. One is the kingdom. Two is the Holy Spirit. Two messages. I'm making myself clear. Receive the kingdom. To re means you had lost it. You got to re get it back again. Re means to get back it. R-E-C-E-V-E means to have. Re means to receive what you have. Jesus made a statement. Mark 10, 14, 15. Let the little children come to me. Do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. Here Jesus explained the kingdom of God is like a child. He said, let them come to me. Like a child go to his parents. Look to his parents for everything, for safety, for food. Look to his parents for guidance, protection. Look to his parents for shelter. Look to his parents for love. Jesus said that I say to you, am I talking to you? Whosoever do not receive the kingdom as of God like a child shall not enter into it. You've been preaching over 30 years, 40, 50 years, and still not received the kingdom. What about those folk you have been hindering from not receiving it? The kingdom is the number one priority in your life. The number one priority in life. He said, receive. I say to you, whosoever do not receive the kingdom of God like a child, you should be teachable. You may be, have a doctor of divinity, master. You may have your doctors. You may have also business management and all sorts of degree. You may be pastoring a church for so much years. You need to receive the kingdom of God in your life. Shall not enter in. That's Mark 10, 14, 15. The kingdom of God is the number one priority that you should receive in your life. Number one priority, he said, but seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Matthew 6:33. But seek ye first to discover, to seek, to pursue, to investigate. Seek is very important. You pursue it, you run after it. But seek it first. Not the Baptist, not a Catholic, not a denomination, not the Seventh-day Adventist, not the cross, not a wife, not a job, but seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness. The word righteousness is the legal word. It's right line, right standing with God, right relationship with the king. Seek the right relationship with the king and his kingdom. Everything shall be added to you. Hebrews 12:28-29. Therefore, since we are receiving not a religion, not a church doctrine, not the church attendance, not to join the choir, not to be in a church group, not to be in a singing group, not to attend largely the church, since you have, we are now receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken. The corona epidemic, COVID-19, had shaken, rocked the world in America in fear and panic. But when you're in the kingdom, there's no fear, there's no panic, there's no shaking. The economy had been shaken around the world. Folks had lost their job, lost their business. Many businesses have closed in America. You can still be in the kingdom and stand all these crises and all this shaking of nation. Receive the kingdom that cannot be shaken. Be thankful. Worship God acceptable with reverence and awe. For God is a consuming fire. Receive the Holy Spirit. I'm making myself clear. Receive the Holy Spirit. Christian doctrine for years have preached the wrong message to the earth. How can you receive the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit is the key to receiving the kingdom of God in your life. The Holy Spirit was sent to connect you back to dominion, a kingdom that you lost. That is why the cross, the blood, Calvary, and the resurrection is that you receive the kingdom back in your life. I'll explain. In Acts 8:14-17, when the apostle was in Jerusalem, the apostle was sent one. And why? They were first disciple students. They were graduated by the Lord, the King. When the apostle were in Jerusalem, heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God. It is important that every state in America, the 52 states, receive the word of God. They sent Peter and John to Samaria. When they arrived, they prayed for new believers, kingdom citizens, new believers, which citizens of heaven who were there, that they might receive the Holy Spirit. Here, Christians got a doctrine. They teach that you go to the altar and you say the sinner prayer. I was deceived by it myself, till I know it is error. You say the sinner prayer, Lord, come in my heart. Forgive me, I'm a sinner. Wash me in your blood. And they announce that you are a Christian. And you're saved. And you're on your way to heaven. The Bible never teaches that. That is a man-made doctrine. Made by your evangelical teachers. Did not made from heaven. Now this was made from heaven. But the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit had not yet came on them, then had simply believed, being baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Then Peter and John placed their hand on them, and they receive the kingdom, the Holy Spirit in their life. The word receive means to receive it back what you lost. Adam lost dominion by unemployed cherub. Receive the kingdom. How can you receive the kingdom? John 20, 21, 22. Jesus Christ, our King, our Savior, our Liberator, Jesus Christ said to them again, peace be with you. As the Father sent me, even I am sending you. Jesus was sent from heaven by the Father. He was on a kingdom diplomat assignment, an envoy, a diplomat sent from heaven. God the Father was in heaven, sent Jesus Christ to earth as a kingdom diplomat, sent by a king. As the Father sent me, even so I am sending you. And when he said this, he breathed. On them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. He connected them back to the kingdom of God and to their dominion, to royal power, to kingship, to government, to the kingdom. Genesis 2:7. The creation. Then the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed in the nostril of man, and he received the breath of life, and man became a living spirit, a living soul. First time he breathed at the creation. Into my nostril. Man was created our forefather named Adam. Adam lost the Spirit of God in his life because of sin, smother the Spirit of God. He commits sin, transgression, and rebellion against God. He lost the Father, he lost the Spirit of God, and he lost the dominion. He was spiritually dead. Every human, 7.7 billion human on the earth, are born spiritually dead without the Holy Spirit. Your government, your prime minister, your president, your mayor, your representative, they do not have the Holy Spirit. The ungenerated man leading your government. To lead the government, you got to be led to govern by wisdom, by knowledge, and by understanding. I'm going to make it myself clear. First time, he breathed in man also. Second time, he breathed on them. It is important that you be connected back to the kingdom of God. That you receive the kingdom of God in your life. Am I making myself clear? John 14, 23, 24. Jesus answered and said to him, if anyone love me, there are millions of people in churches, and you hear the testimony all the time. They say they love God, and all on the bio, and all on their bio, they say that Jesus is the first priority if you love me. Well, the proof will come if you really love God. How do you know a person loves God? How do you know? It's not by lip, by saying, by your lip, by your mouth. It's a deed, it's action. Jesus said to him, if anyone love me, he will keep my word. The word keep means to live, practice, live life living of my word in his life. He will practice it, he will do it. And my Father will love him. And we will come and make a home in him. A lot of folk go looking for Jesus. They go into the church looking to find God. God said, you don't have to look for me. I will come to you to attract God to come to you. You got to love him. You got to keep his word. Then he will come. Him and the Father will come to you and make our resident. Make our permanent resident in your life. Am I making myself clear? If any man keep my word, my Father will love him, and we will come and make our home with him. You don't have to go look for God. God, I'm coming to you. But you got to do this. You got to keep his word. You say you love him. Going to church to mean you love God. Singing in the choir to mean you love God. Preaching a sermon on a pulpit to mean you love God. It's doing, obeying his law, obeying his word. 24th verse, John 14, 24. He who do not love me, do not keep my word. And the word which you hear is not mine, but the Father who sent me. 25th verse. These things have I spoken to you while I was present with you. But the governor, the helper, the key to connect you to the kingdom, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name. He will teach you. It don't say the Holy Ghost is going to preach to you. Many people hawking and spitting and say the Holy Ghost preaching. That's a lie. The Holy Ghost don't preach. The Holy Ghost teach. There are difference between teaching and preaching. Preaching is propagating, like you spread the news, announcing. But teaching is transformation, to transform, to activate, to transfer the information that is in God, in Christ, in your life. I will transform the information that was in the kingdom in your life. I will teach. I will what? Teach. The Holy Ghost will teach you all things. But the Holy Ghost will teach you all things and bring to you, to your remembrance, all things I've said to you. If you do not study, you do not pray, your most important time on your job, in basketball, and sports, most of the important time is in entertainment and the things you love. Fishing, on your car, boating, sightseeing, whatever you do. Well, you got to take time and let the Holy Spirit teach you the word. If you don't have no word in you, how can he bring it to your remembrance? He need to bring what you have in you, in your life. Bring all things to your remembrance. Romans 4:17. How can you receive the kingdom? The kingdom is not a church. The kingdom is not a religion. The kingdom is a government led by a king. For the kingdom of God is not matter of eating, not fellowship, not going to Golden Corral or restaurant or wherever, or having a party, or having a meal or supper, not meeting or drinking, but peace, joy, righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. A, righteousness, right relationship with God. Peace from quietness and quietness, war and argument and strife, and chaos around the world, and all this chaos and crisis was going on. Peace and joy, making melody in your heart unto God, being joyful in the Holy Spirit. Mark 2:6-13. Said these words, for the kingdom, for thine is the kingdom, yours is the kingdom, is yours. The power, the kingdom of God is the power, the authority over epidemic, over sickness, disease, financial crisis, or pain. All crisis, power, and glory forever. When you have a kingdom in your life, you have power, glory, the anointing of God in your life forever and ever. Am I making myself clear? Hosea for my people, 4 and 6. 4 and 4 and 6. For my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. For my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. The word knowledge means Jesus. The word knowledge means the King of Glory. In him, Jesus dwelt the fullness of Godhead, and Jesus dwelt in all wisdom and knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, Jesus, I also reject you. You don't want me, I don't want you, Jesus. I reject you. And you shall be no more priest, no more preacher, no more evangelist, no more pastor, no more bishop, no more prophet, no more leadership. You shall be not to me. You shall not represent me on the earth. Because you have rejected knowledge. Many pastors and leaders still haven't church and been fired. Been fired by God. Because they're preaching without knowledge. They're preaching only church doctrine. The cross, the blood, Calvary. The cross, the blood, Calvary. All through the year. The cross, the blood, Calvary. That's no knowledge. The cross, the blood, Calvary. The cross, the blood, Calvary. The cross, the blood. Every week, every Sunday, the cross, the blood, Calvary. No knowledge. Because they reject me, knowledge. Also reject. There should be no praise unto me. Because they have forsaken the law of God. I have reject their children. I want reject their children. Am I making myself clear? Hallelujah. Because they have reject me, I reject them. And they shall be no more priests unto me. The world has not known you, but we have known you through Jesus Christ. And we come to you, Holy Father. Keep every believer, every kingdom citizen through your word. Help them receive the knowledge that comes from God. Increase in wisdom. I pray that they will receive the Holy Ghost in their life. Breathe upon them one more time. That they will receive the anointing of God in their life. Hallelujah. I worship you, Lord God. I praise your name. Holy, holy unto God. Our Father, God in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our debtor. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Our channel on YouTube. Go to the button and subscribe to our videos. Thank you for being our subscriber. Thank the pastor of Manila, Philippines, and the United States of America. Pastor Jason Webb, Ambassador. Pastor Elvera, Ambassador of Global Diplomat College Center, and all the subscribers, and all those believers and citizens of the kingdom around the world. Till next session, this is Joseph, God Holy Prophet, Ambassador. May God bless you, bless your family. May God restore America back again. May God bless the United States and restore America back again to the original America it used to be. Bless the nation of the earth. To next session, Joseph Forbes, God Holy Prophet, Ambassador.